So before we get started, I just want to bring your attention to something. If you go back to Chapter 1 module, this assignment 3 is a continuation of an activity that you did or should have done under Chapter 1. If you go to read Chapter 1, Interactive Practice, everyone should have done the Chapter 1 example problem. That would have helped you on your homework, and that would have helped you understand the material. And you'll see here it says print the template. So pause the video at this point, go get a copy of that, and I'll wait here. Great, you should have a copy of it. I have mine on Excel, so I just pulled up my solution file from that exercise. And this information I'm going to actually be using for my activity. And then in addition to that, you're also going to need page 44 from your textbook, so you can get the loose leaf version, or you can pull up the ebook version, and you're going to go to the textbook on page 44, and you're going to pull up the information as it relates to problem 1-7B. So pause, go get that information, and once you have it, you are ready to, let's see. You're ready to complete the assignment. So we're going to go back to home. Chapter 2. And we're going to click on Course Activity 3, JE Posting and Trial Balance. Hopefully you have memorized the normal balances for all account types. If you haven't, grab a note card and follow along. Since I already know the normal balances, I'm going to go ahead and skip on to using the transaction information directions. From problem 1-7B, page 44, complete the following. First requirement, prepare the necessary journal entries for each transaction. If you're not clear which process to use, there are examples on page 61, so I added an actual page number to the assignment to give you a little more guidance, and it's on page 60 through 68. We'll give you several different examples on journalizing. Then the second thing you'll need to do is post the journal entries prepared in step 1 to T accounts using the following. So you're going to do the posting process to the general ledger, and an example of posting can be found on page 62 of your reading. And what you'll do is you'll use these accounts right here, and there are account numbers and account names. So this will help you in one, journalizing and in your posting process. And then three, you will prepare a trial balance based on 1 and 2. An example of the trial balance is on page 70. You will create your own file in Excel or use the following. I highly recommend you use the following. The file is already prepared for you, created for you to make it a little simpler. And what you'll find is that if you click on this file, you should have free access to the Office, Microsoft Office 365, or the downloaded version free to all students at Fresno City College. And you can open up that file. And when you open up that file, it'll have the formats that you'll need. Just make sure you click on Enable Editing first. And it's on page 44. You'll see some directions. Let me pull this up a little bit so you can see everything. And at the bottom left-hand side, you'll see links, analysis, journal entry, general ledger, and trial balance. Analysis is just optional. It's a way to help you analyze the transactions using the concept of normal balances and what is actually occurring in the accounting equation. The journal entry, this is step 1 where you're journalizing. And then GL, that's where you're going to do the posting. It has all of the T accounts. And then the trial balance, this is what you'll do for step 3. So you have everything that you need. And if we go back to the instructions in Canvas, it goes on to say upload the file or take a picture of your trial balance and submit it through Canvas. So if you prefer, you can print this out if it's easier for you to work on. And then all you have to do is just take a photograph of your completed trial balance and upload that to Canvas. If not, you can just complete it on the Excel file. So that's all you need to do for this assignment. Now, I will go ahead and take you through a couple of them so that you can start or get started. So the first one is going to be based on these instructions. So June 1st, Nina Nico invested $130,000 cash in the company in exchange for its common stock. So we're going to use what we did previously in Chapter 1, and you'll see on June 1st, we have a positive or increase to cash for $130. We have an increase to our common stock of $130. And so when we do our journal entry for the analysis, we'll have the date, we'll have the two accounts, cash and common stock. Cash is an asset. Common stock is an equity item. The normal balance of cash is debit. The normal balance of common stock is credit. We are increasing our cash and we are increasing our common stock. So we will debit cash and credit common stock. That's the analysis portion where we're analyzing the transactions. And then when you go to the prepare the actual journal entry, what you'll find is that you'll just debit. I'll make it a little bigger. You will debit cash, so list it first, leave the reference column blank. You'll then list the $130,000 for debit, and then you will indent, and you will credit the account common stock, and you'll put in the amount of $130,000, and you will leave the reference column blank, and you are done with your first journal entry. So the second one, let's do one more. The company rented a furnished office and paid $6,000 cash for rent. So how will we do that? Well, we'll go to the analysis page. But before we do that, I want to see what I put down for my analysis back in Chapter 1. And I have a decrease to cash. And I have a decrease to my stockholders' equity. So here I'm actually increasing my expenses, which have an inverse relationship with my equity. So the more expenses I have, the smaller my retained earnings, the smaller my stockholders' equity. So this will be a decrease to my right side, my equity side, in the form of rent expense. So when I do my analysis, again, this is optional. I'm just showing you what I'm doing in my head. Let me go ahead. Go ahead and put down June 2nd, and the two accounts were cash and rent expense. Type of account, cash is an asset. Rent expense is an expense which falls under equity. It decreases our equity. The normal balance of cash is debit. Normal balance of an expense is debit as well. Cash is decreasing by the $6,000. And rent expense, our expenses are increasing. So our expenses are increasing, but our equity, overall equity, is decreasing. But since we're looking only at the rent expense, it's increasing. So if our cash has a normal balance of debit, and we want to decrease it, we will then credit the cash account. Rent expense has a normal balance of debit, and we want to increase it, so we're going to have to debit rent expense. So this is our analysis, and then when we do our journal entry, we're going to skip a space, put in the date of the transaction, and then we are going to list the account to be debited first. So that means we must list rent expense first. And we're going to debit that, $6,000. And then we're going to indent, do our credit to cash. And we are going to credit at $6,000. Our debits equal our credits. And we're ready for our next one. So we'll use that process of journalizing. Let's go down to the next one. That was June 4th. And our detail says the company purchased 2,400 of equipment on credit. So for our problem, we'll look at our analysis. In June 4th, we had equipment and we also had accounts payable. So on our journal entry, we're going to do our analysis first. Again, this part is optional. I'm just showing you what's going on in my head. Some will also use T accounts to figure out the debits and credits. I'm just going to do a visual analysis. That will be equipment. And accounts payable, because we're going to owe this amount, pay it off in the future. Equipment is an asset. Accounts payable is a liability. And if equipment is an asset, normal balance is debit for equipment. Normal balance for liabilities is credit. It's on the right side, so credit. Here go my normal balances. And I am increasing my equipment account, $2,400. And I'm increasing my credit. Now I owe my creditors $2,400 on account. And if I'm increasing my asset equipment, I will debit it. And since I'm increasing my debt, I will credit it because the normal balance is credit. That's my analysis, and I journalize the date after skipping the space. And we're going to list our debits first, so we'll type in equipment, we'll indent, we'll type in accounts payable, also known as AP, and the amount, we'll skip the reference of column, we'll leave that blank, we don't use that until we begin our posting. And you'll just do that for all the problems. That's your journaling process. Now, item two, step says post the journal entries. You're going to use these accounts. So I'll just post the first one for you so you'll know what we're doing. Cash, $130,000 on the debit side. So you will put it under the debit side. And the date is the 1st of June. So 6-1 will be our cross-reference. And the journal entry, we'll put in the account 101. And then for the common stock, we'll put that on the credit side, the 130. So you'll look for common stock, 130. And that too occurred on June 1st.